negative elements. There's a lot of symmetry to this molecule, right? You got your oxygen right here. Well, this side has carbon with a nitrogen, carbon nitrogen. Down here, the ring hanging off is just one nitrogen to a carbon. Let's see, any other? Here's one. So see, we do this before the hydrogens. This way we can really focus in on the carbons. And those are all going to get twos. There's no double bonds there, so watch. We're going to start at the bottom. Each of these carbons is just like a straight chain. So see, one, two H's on these. Benzene ring only gets one H, but these are all CH2s. Yeah. One on top, one on bottom to kind of give us that 3D effect. So they all get the scarlet diamond color, right? And what do we got up here? Looks like a one, huh? Put you all on screen. See, I'm looking at the paper, so I don't always look at the camera. I apologize. But it's bending my back just to reach and do this anyway. So CH1s are brown. So do we got every type of carbon? I don't see any methyl groups, huh? Had every kind of nitrogen, but only three types of the carbons. So again, that's MinOXiDil. MinOXiDil. Min, the ox, is probably named for the oxygen. I don't know where the min or the idol comes from, but lots of nitrogens up there, huh? It's a potassium channel opener and a vasodilator. So they were using it for your high blood pressure. And it was a side effect. Found made your hair grow. And they still don't know how. But boy, they'll sell it to you, won't they? Over the counter. I'm going to check the sound. Okay, this is a cool looking molecule too. This is the active ingredient in Head and Shoulders. So what I want to find out is, that one movie said it was the zinc, or the selenium. Now it's a zinc that's in the middle of this. So this is what we're drawing here. See the symmetry? Two rings on each side. These are the same things. And boy, it's got oxygen, copper. Gosh, oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, and sulfur. So let's start in the middle. We're going to need a zinc. Probably not going to have enough room on this page. Metals like zinc. We don't have a silver. I have a silver crayon. I should go dig it out. So here's zinc. Since it's got four bonds, we'll give it a square. It might only have two, which is what it should do. So let's put kind of a football-y kind of two in there for the zinc. Usually zinc is a 2+. I don't know if this is actually bound, so 2+ or 4+. I don't know. But anyway, there's zinc. Going to be an ion, so we'll even circle it in red, because red is positive, remember? I'm not even on screen. Okay, so zinc. Big old metal element atom in the middle. So even though oxygen's big, sulfur's big. So to draw this, we're going to go O, O. Now the sulfur, I need a sharper pencil is what I'm looking for. Okay, the sulfur's just got a single bound to it. So let's just do the tip of the Star of David. See how easy that works? One bond's going this way, so just put the tip of the star in there. And that keeps those together. So the O goes to the nitrogen. Let's use my fancy colored blue here. So right angled in. Over here we'll do right angle in. Try and back that up a little bit. Now the sulfur is going to go to a diamond. So let's just pick it straight across. No, look, it looks like it kind of goes down, so we could even do it down. Let's do that just to keep it looking cool. So it could go next, but we're going to point it that way. See the beauty of the sulfur with the six? When you get into the real three-dimensional structures of these, you can throw that in there. So now it's just a six-membered ring, a double bond on the... We go from the carbon, we go up one. There's a diamond. And that goes double bound to a diamond. Get all that on camera. So it's a six. Oh, I got too far ahead of myself here. That N is going to be plused because it's got four bonds. So watch this. Here we're going to get this bond to here. And then this bond is going to get the alien mind meld. Need a sharper pencil. So see oxygen there? There. Well, this end needs a plus. It's going to have four bonds on it. So that way, the bottom here will go to the diamond. And that will give a mind meld. The fourth bond goes to there. So that's going to be a Schroeder diamond. Need some yellow for the double bond character here. That looks pretty cool because it is kind of the pi bond, which should be taking a lot of three-dimensional space there. So that N, special N. This is where you're learning your chemistry now. This isn't the straightforward stuff, but it's no biggie, is it? Let's see. That O should probably be bigger than that. Anyway, we got a double bond over here. That's all there is for that. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's one more diamond in between there, and there's no aromaticity to it. So just connect it. Now let's finish this side since the other side is the same. We've got Schroeder diamond here. Just kind of make that really bold. I guess we should draw it, yeah, because it is a bond, right? And then that down there. We've got double bonds there, so those are going to be CH2s here. And CH1's up where the double bond is. So one. Makes these guys brown. Makes us scarlet. See, a molecule like this,